A new day for Spain, yet without a new government. The question on everyone's mind now is what alliances can Pedro Sanchez form with other parties if he is to govern the country. Reactions to the election results are mixed.
I voted for Ciudadanos, so I would obviously like them to join forces so we could have a mix of left and right. But I know that's unlikely to happen because they don't match in a lot of positions.
I think it was a disaster. I think Spain is not ready for what happened.
Despite the smiles during his triumph speech, a solution will not be easy for Sanchez. He will either need the help of left-wing Podemos and regional parties, possibly even Catalan pro-independence parties, or center-right Ciudadanos. Sanchez has barely hinted on his plans.
The only condition we are going to put is respecting the Constitution and promoting social justice towards coexistence and political transparency.
Any negotiations will probably drag for long. That's because analysts say Sanchez would not want to open his cards before the European and regional elections at the end of May. Fernando Fernandez agrees with most analysts that the Spanish prime minister will try to align with leftist Podemos.
One, because Ciudadanos has a chance to fight with the Popular Party on the right, and they will not want to enter into a coalition with the socialist government, with Pedro Sanchez. And two, because Pedro Sanchez is clearly a man on the left of the Socialist Party. He thinks that that Spain needs to lean to the left and to implement more radical, in a sense, leftist policies than the ones that we have been implementing for the last 10 years.
Right-wing parties cannot form a coalition. Ultra-nationalist Vox's success to enter Spanish parliament is seen as a turning point for the far right, which has been gaining popularity across Europe. Spain also has had to deal with the Catalan independence movement, a movement that has boosted Vox. Yet the country's problems go beyond that. Spain has been without a budget for 2019 since it was rejected in February, and Pedro Sanchez called for Sunday's snap election. So a government must be formed as soon as possible as the economy, high unemployment, and the standoff between Madrid and Catalan separatists are only some of the many challenges the new government will have to face. Filio Kontrafouri, CGTN, Madrid.